And welcome back. This is 100 baby challenge, kind of. It's either going to be episode 141 or 142. Haven't quite decided which one I'm posting first, so I don't know. I was going to post the second, but then it was like, oh my goodness, like, I don't want to ruin the gameplay. And like, I was going to record my gameplay today, but my neighbors are being kind of loud. So I'm like, I don't want to risk it. We're just going to do this. I don't want to be cranky when the heir is born. So this is what we're doing. And so I've built the new house for generation three. So if you didn't see the poll results, shame to be you, but pretty much I'll just do a basic thing. The heir is gonna keep some of the money. We're gonna like the color yellow. We're gonna make our money by baking. Our easy trait, I believe, is gonna be materialistic, and our difficult trait, I think, is gonna be, maybe that was our difficult trait. Yeah, materialistic's our difficult trait. Our easy trait is like romantic, I believe, and our other trait's going to be a foodie, and we're going to live in Brindleton Bay, obviously, as you can see, and I think that was it, and we're not having a money tree. I think that's all I had to say, but yeah, you can go check out the poll results. You can see how much people won. You can also hear me talk about how someone was a bad egg and voted too many times and caused me lots of extra work. And we won't talk about that anymore. I promise that's the last time I'm going to mention it, but I'm very disappointed in it. But yeah, so I figured since we're living in a kind of farmy town and someone suggested that we live in a farmhouse, I was like, yeah, we should do a farm build. So this is a house, just kidding, no, that's across the street. So we'll probably maybe be looking at that a lot, I don't know. Beautiful, beautiful. Nice and yellow. Pink did come second in the poll, so I tried to scatter some pink stuff around the place. So we do have the house. So I imagine this is like a renovated kind of farmhouse style kind of thing. So we've got our old barn here, which is where we're going to be letting the heir sleep. I've put a party bush outside so that we can lock it. And so like we can just have the heir in there and like chicken woohoo in the party bush or in the spa, and like the kids won't go in there and bother her. That was actually an idea by my best friend. I was like, oh, that's a good idea, because she suggested to lock it. So I was like, oh, good idea, because perks of being my best friend, you get to see all these beforehand. Oopsies, I didn't do that. There we go. Shh. But yeah, no, so she's seen screenshots of all this already, so I don't know. Friendship perks, right? You gotta have something for putting up with my bad jokes 24/7, right? So this is the house. We've got a fairly simple like toddler area. Oh, I'm doing a house tour today. Should probably mention that. Doing a house tour, decided to do that instead of a speed build because, I don't know, this took me probably 3 or 4 hours to build. And I like to, when I do speed builds, I like it when it only takes me about an hour and a half to build, but I put a lot more work into it than I probably would a normal build. So, you know, it's a bit more detailed and such like that. You can kind of see some sneak peeks through the window here, but that's okay. So I guess I'll show you the outside first, because I'm pretty proud of the outside. I really like the outside, actually. We'll make it nice and bright for you. I don't like that the door looks green there, but I promise you it's yellow. Maybe we'll leave it morning time. So we've just got like a little toddler area for them to play and stuff. I figure too, we could like maybe each season we could put something big here and be like, I don't know, have like a snowman here or a water slide or I don't know, something you can do in a scarecrow or like, I don't know, something autumny, some pumpkin carving stations, and we can have like, I don't know, some fun seasonal activities we could do with the fam bam. But yeah, so that's what I was thinking. That's why I left the space nice and clear. I also kind of thought it might be fun to do the grilled cheese aspiration since we're going to be a foodie, and we can like maybe put a rocket here and go to space. I don't know, because you have to do that for the grilled cheese aspiration. I don't know, could be fun. So let's go through the back. So you can get to the back through a couple ways by going in the house. Oh, I suppose we should look at the front porch. We got a cute little front porch here. Got some sitting area. It's kind of cute. Got a little flamingo over there. But you can see, I tried to use pink as well because it did come second. So there's some hints of pink around the place. And we've got a nice little swing set here. And we've got a nice little, we'll just go down a couple floors. There we go. We've got a nice little, I don't know, entranceway to either come out here from the kitchen or to go to the spa or to head over to the pool area. So we've got a little pool out the back with some nice sunflowers because I love sunflowers. They're my favorite flower and yellow one. So I was like, heck yeah, gotta put some of them in. And we got a nice little table and a barbecue, and we got a little trash can over here and our fire thingy so I don't forget and burn down my Sims. We got a nice little relax area, we got a floater, we got a jumpy buddy, and down here, ooh, we've got a secret area, because you know how it is. I figured this area would be great to either put the butler or the bad children. It's kind of sparsely decorated and kind of ugly-ish, but I don't know, it's okay. I mean, it's not bad, it's just really plain and kind of boring. I tried to make it very, like, gender neutral. If we get a butler, we can put them down here. If we get a new orange Martin or Ginger, we can put them down here. We'll probably make it more ugly to suit their tastes, but, you know, that's for the problem children. So I'm prepared for my problem children this time. They will be going in the basement where they belong. So, that's a good one. So, I guess we'll start by going in the front door, which is here. We've got a cute little, like, I don't know, I imagine it says, like, I don't know, home is where the heart is or something dumb. Like, you know, we love those signs. I don't know. I actually think they're really cute signs, but anyways. we've got a nice little wreath here. I did use a lot of oranges, too, because there's not that many yellow decorations. So, this is the front entrance. We've got, I don't know, some books, like some magazines or something. I imagine, like, you get your catalogs, your newspaper, you chuck it in there. You got your umbrellas, your coats. Maybe you want a snack on your way in. Some letters, a school bag, obviously, because kids. And then we come in pretty much directly into the dining room. We've got some nice little flip-flop lights because you know how I feel about them. I really like them and they match the ones out here, which I think is pretty cute. And then we've got, like, I don't know, I figured birthday cards would be funny to put here because it's like I don't know, we have so many Sim children, it's like, yeah, you all get birthday cards because, you know, everyone's like, yeah, send your birthday card. And we got, I don't know, some cute stuff. And it's just a pretty basic table, just a nice big spot for people to sit at and do their thing. We got a little arts and crafts area, scouts, if we want to join the scouts. I don't know, I thought it kind of matched and looked cute together, so I put them all there. And I guess we'll go have a look at the kitchen. We've got one of these boards because I don't know, we want to go be horrible to our children. We've got, like, a little measure. I don't know, I thought that's something you'd put in here. I really like what I did here. I've ran out of space to put the like the sink and dishwasher, and so I had, like, the fridge in this. And so what I did is I put little extra walls here and, like, made it into brick, which I thought was kind of funky. Same with the dishwasher area, so I thought that was kind of cute. We're gonna put Hamilton here. This is fake Hamilton. I had to put something down so it looks empty. We've got our daisy from our original house. It's kind of the same daisy but kind of not. I, like, copied the room and put my daisy in there and stuff. And yeah, and here's the door out back, so this is where the baby maker can go out and head over to her room. We'll look at that later. I'm not gonna look at that just yet. I think we'll look at that last because that's what I built last. So just off the dining room back in here, we've got a nice little study so they can work on their gaming skills or programming skills, and it's kind of fun. I don't know, it's, like, just kind of cute, colorful pinks, yellows. We've got a, like, bookcase and, I don't know, a little couch to sit on and read your books, and I don't know, it's just kind of cute. And we got just some bathrooms, pretty basic. We got the shower tub combo, the shub. I love it. Just a toilet and a sink and a mirror. And oh, I didn't change these, I wanted to have different colored ones. Oh well, that's fine, I like the moon. We can just look at the same picture in all the bathrooms, doesn't really matter, whatever, right? And then we got a little living room. It's kind of, I don't know how I feel about the living room. I'm still not 100% sold on it, but I kind of like it. It's fairly basic, you know, you got some pink and yellow couches. I feel like it was kind of fun to have it mismatched. We got some kids' toys. We've got a decorations box because we can finally decorate. We couldn't decorate in the apartment because it's like years, like you can't decorate even though you're in a penthouse and you have like a roof. You can't do that. I was like, really? Really? Yeah, I can't do that. So we can put our decorations up again, which I think will be fun. And we've got, like, I don't know, chessboard so we can, like, make kids skill build and stuff and watch TV, play games, you know, all that jazz. Good times, good times. So, upstairs, we have the baby walls. So we've got all the Generation 1 photos up here. Just as you come up the stairs, we've kept our photos. Again, I copied them all into a room and I haven't updated that yet. So my apologies, fixed it now. We've got the Generation 2 photos. Haven't given birth to the air yet, so we don't have anything to put there, but they will go there when we have them. And this is where I'm going to put Generation 3. I originally had like windows here, but then I'm like, dang it, where am I going to put my baby photos? And it looks really dark in it without windows, so I put these here. I'm going to upload a normal version without all the photos of my children so you guys don't have to look at them. But yeah, this is like the kind of landing area. I did like lots of skill building stuff in here. We've got the kids' violin. We've got a keyboard. We've got a little block building thing so they can play that. We've got a little teddy bear. We've got darts. We've got more bathrooms. We have 4 bathrooms in this house instead of 3. So I think that'll really ease up things in the morning, help me get along. And I guess I did this room first, so we'll have a look at it first. This is the sunroom. I themed each room over the sun and the moon because, I don't know, I thought that was kind of fun. So, and I think they're fairly gender neutral colors, so works for any gender. So we've got, I don't know, a little puppet thingy for the kids to play with. We've got desks for everyone to do their homework on. We've got beds, we've got toys, we've got sunscreen because it's the sun. Haha, very funny. Just a little bookcase and yeah, just like a little mirror so they can look at themselves, and I don't know, it's yellow and cute, and yeah, I don't know. And then we've got the moon room, the space room, and again, fairly simple. We've got, I don't know, some stars here, beds for everyone, nice little teddy bear. We've got a desk. I don't know if they can do homework on it. I'll probably delete some of that stuff, but yeah, I don't know. This is for the more edgy people, but again, fairly gender neutral. We've got a little science table for the kids and somewhere for them to get changed, and I don't think we have a mirror in here. No, we don't. That's fine. They don't need a mirror. I don't have a mirror in my room, so yeah, you know, whatever. I don't know. It's kind of fun. It's like, I don't know, it's a bit more galaxy crystal alternative kind of themed, I guess. I don't know. I like it. So that's kind of cool. And then we have the toddlers over here. I only have 3 toddler beds. If we need to, I can like reorganize these so we have 4. Like I can push that over one and put a bed here. But I think for now, 3 looks pretty cute. And I don't know. I quite like it. Let's just turn the light on. It still looks fairly dark in here. Yeah, whatever. And we've got like a little, obviously, a dollhouse. We've got stuff for them to work on their skills. We've got some little tablets. We've got some chairs for them to sit on because I think this will really help with the whole when they need to eat. I can just like drag food up here and they can sit here because like a lot of the times they try to sit on the beds and they, I don't know what it is, but they like get up and like they don't finish their meal. I don't know. It's dumb. We've got a little toy chest. We've got a little bookcase so they can read if they want to because they can read toddler books by themselves, which is pretty cool. And they've got their own little bathroom as well so we can like bathe them if the air's up nice and early and the kids want to like use the actual bathrooms. We can just like use this one. It's a dedicated bathroom and we've got the potties in here and like, you know, we can hide it like that so it's not like a stinky mess all the time and we don't have to look at it. So yeah, there you go. So people who get upset about the stinky potties don't need to be upset because we won't have to look at it. So there you go. And so, now we shall head downstairs again, and because that's all there is. There's no more upstairs. We've just got, you know, I suppose I should show you the floor plan. We've just got like two bedrooms, the toddler room, enough for eight kids, technically even more with all the toddler beds. We've got four bathrooms, a nice big living space, nice big things, and nice big backyard and all that sort of stuff that you could need. There's heaps of room for skill building objects and all that jazz. So there we go. We've got plenty of space and plenty of stuff, and it's not too expensive. It's, yeah, $250,000. So that's about how much I wanted the house to cost. So I'm pretty on budget. I'll probably give the heir a similar amount. Maybe, yeah, I don't know. I haven't quite decided how I'm going to work that out. But this is the heir's zone room area, which will be locked off to the kids. We've got our cupcake making machine in here. We've got some bookcases for her to do some reading. We've got a TV so she can just watch a movie in peace. Like, yes, queen. And we've got a little computer back here too for her to use, because if, I don't know, if the baking doesn't work out the greatest for money making, we can do like, we could get a freelancer job or a work from home job or something like that. And I figured we'd need a computer if we did that. So I might as well put one in. So yeah, she's got a bathroom down here as well. Because she is materialistic, I tried to make it a little bit fancy. So we got the fancy stuff from Get Famous, and we've got some sunflowers because she likes yellow. And I don't know, I went through this, I don't know, I put lots of, her whole place is brick, because, like, I don't know, I thought it was kind of fun to have, like, a red brick barn. I was gonna have it painted red, but I'm like, red isn't the color that won, so, and it felt weird to me to have, like, a yellow barn, so I was like, no, thank you, I'll just have red brick, thank you very much. And we've got, like, a little loft-style bedroom for my girl here, so we've got, like, I don't know, just this cute little outlook up here for her, and she's got, like, little paintings, and I don't know. It's just like a small kind of cozy room, I guess. It's like, you know, it's not as fancy as Zoe's room, which is kind of interesting because Zoe isn't very, wasn't materialistic. But I figured if I went to like opulent, rich and like, I don't know, stuff like that, it would look really weird with like the brick and the barn walls and stuff like that. So I went for more country style. So this bed's actually really good for energy. We've got a yoga mat because I find yoga's a great way to keep the Sims who are like having babies a lot fairly fit. Like you saw how ripped Zoe got. We just got a nice little yellow lamp. I don't know. I feel like it's just nice and kind of homey and comfy and cute, and like we've got some candles and stuff and some little sunflowers and plant, nice place to sit, and I don't know, nice little cupboard, and I don't know, I feel like it's a nice relaxing space, and I don't know, I think it's a good spot for her to be because it's just like, I imagine it would be fairly quiet, and she could also look out the window too and like see the toddlers playing if she wanted to and stuff, I don't know, but that's like what I was going for, just like a relaxing kind of like country vibe space. I painted this wall here to have like the same stuff as the toddler because it's kind of yellow and pink and red, which is all the colors that were in the poll, so I thought that was kind of fun. And yeah, I don't know, I'm still not 100% sold on this rug, so we may change it, but you know, it's yellow. We might change it to be something else, but for now I think that's what I'm gonna go with. I don't know, it's what I've locked in, but yeah, I'm pretty happy with it. I don't know, it's simple, but I feel like the items in here are of good quality, and I feel like the heirs really gonna like a lot of bright colors, so that's why I kind of gone for like these kind of looks, and like, I don't know, that's what I was going for, just like a really bright, kind of vibrant, happy kind of home that's quite warm, and I don't know, stuff like that, so yeah, that's good fun. And we've also got the thing down the basement again. And this rug fit perfectly in here. I was like, yes, that looks great in the pool. I don't normally put stuff at the bottom of the pools, but I thought that looked pretty heckin' awesome. But yeah, I don't know. So that's it. That's the Generation 3 home. We will be living here for probably 50 to 80 episodes. That's about usually how many episodes it takes me to have 25 kids. But, you know, we'll be here, and I don't know, I hope you guys like it, and I'm really keen to move on to Generation 3 and hang out with y'all and keep on playing together and, I don't know, progressing the story, and I'm really happy, and I'm excited to see where we take this series, and I don't know. I hope it. I like it. It's smaller than our old house, but I think that's kind of what you guys were going for when you voted. You didn't want me to have as much money. So we've still got everything we need. We've got more than enough to live here, but it's not super extravagant like what it was for Zoe. I mean, it wasn't super extravagant, but it was like a modern home. It was kind of nice for me to build like a more country style home because I haven't really built that in a while. I've been doing lots of modern builds, so this was kind of fun. But anyways, thank you all for watching. I don't know what episode number this is because I don't know when I'm going to post this one. So there you go. But I hope you're excited for Generation 3. I sure am. And I don't know, just get excited. It's go time. Baby time. More babies. Yes. Oh, I can't believe I'm so excited about sim babies. I'm not like this with real children. I'm like, ugh, please stay away. Please, just very far away. But anyways, thank you all for watching, and I will see you all next time. Bye-bye!